If you use Microsoft PowerPoint 2016 to create your presentations, let me share with you 6 features you might not know exist. Hey, welcome to another Talking Tech with the Techie Guy. My name is Liron Segev, where I make technology simple. So this week I had to give my yearly presentation. It's my social media marketing trends 2018. And I discovered a couple of hidden features that I didn't know existed within Microsoft PowerPoint. So I thought, let me share them with you.
So if you have an image on the screen and you don't want the background, you just want the football as an example, you don't have to go into a photo editing program to do that. You can just click on Format and click on the option called Remove Background. Now, Microsoft doesn't get this 100% all the time, but it does do a great job in removing the background. See, it's highlighted in pink. You see there's a little bit of grass underneath the ball. I'm just going to click on the tool that allows me to select specific areas that I want to be removed. So you click on that, then you use your mouse to highlight the areas that the background removal tool missed. Right, now just click on Apply Changes and ta-da, you've got your image without the background. So the human eye is always drawn to movement. So if you want to have an object on the screen, instead of it being static, you can actually move it around. Now go into animation, click on the 3 little dots that drops down that additional features, and this time choose Custom Path. Now with your mouth, go and draw the exact path that you want the object to follow. It could be as complicated as you like. When you're finished, press the Enter button, and now your object will follow that path. Now you can also move it around. You can edit the path location as well. Just drag and drop these things around. If you add sound to your presentations, like an audio file, you can go into Insert, Audio, from your PC, select the file. Now you would normally press play and then it will basically play the audio file, right? But what happens if you want to jump to specific points in that audio file? You've got something called Add Bookmarks. Simply select the location, click on Add Bookmark, and when you go play your file, you can simply jump straight away to those bookmarks. Now that's pretty cool. Now with a file, let's just say it's too long, or you don't want the entire audio, you just want a certain section of that, you can trim it. Go to Playback, Trim Audio, simply take the green pointer on the left side, drag it just to the point where you want to start the trim, the red to the point you want to end the trim, and now click OK, and only that portion will be now available within your video. So at times we just want to have some random text so we can just see what the layout would look like. So if you just type this command equals rand brackets and press enter, it will just automatically insert that sentence for you. And then you can play with the layout to see what some random text would look like. Now if you don't want all your text to be exactly the same, you can always use this command. So insert a new text box, and just type this lorem brackets, and then it will give you this random sentence that you've seen everywhere. When I do my presentations, I like to have some videos for visual effect, and usually you would have to press insert video and select the video file from your computer. Now that makes the PowerPoint presentation really, really big. But now in 2016, you've also got the ability to actually have insert video, which is hosted on the internet, either on your OneDrive, YouTube. You can basically click on there, press the channel name or the video you're looking for, select it, and then insert it. Another option is to use the embed code. So if you go to insert video and this time select embed, you can embed videos not from YouTube, for example, from Vimeo. Let me show you an example, one that is from YouTube. So click on the embed, you go into your YouTube video, find the video that you want to stick into your presentation, click on share, and then click on the embed. Now you'll have an embed code. Click on that, press copy, head back to your presentation, and then simply paste the code in there. You can create a shortcut for any word that you type repeatedly. Click on File, click on Options, Proofing, and then Autocomplete. And now under your replace, you can create a shortcut. So I write TTG, and I want to replace it with the Techie Guy. Now I click on Add. And okay. So now when I go back into my presentation, all I've got to do is simply use the short code. So those are my tips. If you know of anyone who needs help with PowerPoint, share this video. Maybe they'll find some of these tips interesting. If you've got any other tips for me, leave them in the comments below. If you're new here, smash that subscribe button. Check out these other cool videos, and I'll see you guys on the next episode of Talking Tech with the Techie Guy. Cheers for now.